Hi, my dear students. So, based upon yesterday's last formula, I'm going to discuss one more problem. So, limit n tends to infinity n minus root of n square plus n. See, if you apply infinity, it takes the indeterminate form infinity minus infinity form. So that means we can't apply here limit of the function limit directly. Then, how to evaluate this limit? So just I'm approaching one of the basic method rationalization, because here numerator, because this can be written as whole divided by 1 also, okay, here numerator contains what irrational terms, so better rationalize. So what will be the rationalization factor? N plus root of n square plus n by n plus root of n square plus n. So it is equal to numerator, you can use a plus b into a minus b formula. What you will get? A square minus b square, n square minus of root n square plus n whole square divided by n plus root of n square plus n. So that square root get cancelled, then what you will get? Limit n tends to infinity n square minus into plus n divided by, here you take n common, that means what you will get? 1 plus root of n square plus n divided by n. So it is equal to limit n tends to infinity. Here n square get cancelled. Why I have taken n common? Because numerator highest n power is 1, denominator also highest n power is 1. Because root of n square is what? N. Okay. So minus n divided by n into 1 plus. Here if you take this n is inside the square root, that becomes n square. So square root of n square plus n divided by n square. Now this n and n get cancelled. So limit n tends to infinity minus 1 divided by 1 plus square root of, separate n square by n square is 1, plus n by n square is 1 by n. Now as n tends to infinity, 1 by n is what? Tending to 0. So applying that, what you'll get? Minus 1 by 1 plus square root of 1 plus 1 by n is 0. So thus minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 is the answer. So next problems based upon sandwich theorem. So what is the sandwich theorem statement? Suppose f of x, g of x, h of x, they are related to in this. So suppose f of x less than or equal to g of x less than or equal to h of x for all x belongs to neighborhood of A. So in the neighborhood of A, this is the relation between f, g and h, such that a limit extends to A, f of x is L, and limit extends to A, h of x is also L. Limit extends to A, f of x is L. Limit extends to A, h of x is L. And in the neighborhood of A, this is the relation between f, g, h. Then automatically limit extends to A, g of x is also what you'll get? L. So this implies that what we can conclude, limit extends to A, g of x is also equal to what? L. Now using this property, I'm going to solve a problem, some problems. Okay. So the problem is, first problem, limit extends to 0, x into sine of 1 by x. So don't say I'm writing this x as 1 by x, this x as divided by 1 by x, so sine x by x form 1. So that is wrong. Because sine x by x form, but that x must be what, tending to 0. But here instead of x, what do we have? 1 by x. So whether 1 by x tending to 0, according to this given data, this given problem? No. So we can't write that as sine of 1 by x by 1 by x further. If it is x is tending to infinity, then x into sine 1 by x can be written as sine 1 by x by 1 by x, where 1 by x is tending to 0 only, when x tends to infinity. But here x tending to what? 0. So you can't write this as sine of 1 by x by 1 by x. You can't apply sine x by x as x tends to 0 is 1, that formula. Okay? So here, then how to evaluate this? So remember one thing. When x is tending to 0, sine of 1 by x does not exist, because this sine of 1 by x is an oscillating number. Oscillating number. And it is oscillating between minus 1 and plus 1. Oscillating between minus 1 and plus 1. So that means when x tends to 0, sine 1 by x is, does not exist. It is always oscillating between minus 1 and 1. So limit of sine 1 by x as x tends to 0 does not exist. But we know that it is a finite number. It is a finite number. So which is lie between minus 1 and plus 1. So minus 1 less than or equal to sine 1 by x less than or equal to 1. So multiply with the x. Then minus x less than or equal to x into sine 1 by x less than or equal to x into 1x. So here you consider x is positive. So in case of x negative also you will get same. Answer finally limit is same only. Okay. Now it is look like f less than or equal to g less than or equal to h. So now I am finding limit x tends to 0. This f function, what will get? 0. And limit x tends to 0. This h of x function is again 0. So limit x tends to 0. This function and this function both are tending to 0. So hence by Sandwich theorem, limit x tends to 0, this middle function is also tending to what? 0 only. So this implies that by Sandwich theorem, limit x tends to 0, x into sine of 1 by x is equal to 0. So using Sandwich theorem, I got this answer. And you try this problem also. To try limit x tends to 0, x into cos 1 by x. So further also what you will get? With the same steps what you will get? 0. Because cos of 1 by x is also what? Always lie between minus 1 and 1 only. Next problem. So next problem we can do using Sandwich theorem, or without using Sandwich theorem also we will get there. Further question answer. So I am doing that problem. I am not using for that Sandwich theorem. Okay. So problem is a limit n tends to infinity. Step of x plus step of 2x plus step of 3x plus and so on. Plus and so on. Step of nx divided by n square. So this is the previous year mains model problem, but not the same, okay? So here n is tending to infinity, x is some constant. Here n, x is not a variable, here n is a variable, okay? So that means this sum is going to what? As n tends to infinity, this number of terms in this series is what? Infinite. Divided by n square. Then how to evaluate this? See here. This problem can also be written as numerator series in the form of sigma notation. Sigma r is running from 1 to n. Step of rx divided by n square. See, first term is 1 into x, second term is 2x, third term is 3x, last and so on. Nth term is step of nx. So rth term will be step of rx, and r is running from 1 to n. So So limit n tends to infinity. So further, how to evaluate this here? Sigma r is equal to 1 to n. So we know that any real number x is equal to any real number, or you take y is equal to integral part of y plus fractional part of y. Is it correct? Every real number can be written as y. If y is any real number, y is equal to what? Integral part of y plus fractional part of y. So from that, integral part of y becomes what? Y minus fractional part of y. So I'm using that formula here. So it is like a y. Step of y. Step of y is equal to what? Y minus fractional part of y. Here also what I can write? Rx minus fractional part of Rx. Whole divided by n square. So now apply sigma separately and also apply limit also separately. Okay. So limit n tends to infinity. Sigma r into x divided by n square. R is running from 1 to n. Minus limit n tends to infinity. Sigma r is running from 1 to n. Fractional part of rx divided by n square. So limit n tends to infinity, sigma r is running from 1 to n, r is nothing but sum of the first n natural numbers, because if you expand the sigma, what you'll get? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on n. So that is sum of first n natural numbers, so which is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2, this sigma r into x as it is divided by n square, minus this value will be 0, y. Fractional part of Rx means it is what? It is a sum. Finite value. It is lie between what? 0 to 1. But down what we have? Infinite. So finite by infinite, what you will get? 0. So this is a finite value. Okay. Now here 1 n get cancelled. So limit n tends to infinity. N plus 1 by n. Into x by 2. This x by 2. So here, numerator degree, denominator degree same. And n is tending to what? Infinity. Then what is the answer? Leading coefficient by leading coefficient is the limit of this function. So here, what is the leading coefficient? 1. Here also 1. So limit of this function is equal to what? 1. So 1 into x by 2. X by 2. So this is the answer. Okay, next problem. So take these two problems as homework. So take 1 square into x, 2 square into x, 3 square into x, n square into x divided by n cube. So you need to get the answer is x by 3. Answer is what? X by 3. Next, the same problem with cubes. 1 cube x, step of 1 cube x plus step of 2 cube x plus step of 3 cube x plus and so on, step of n cube x divided by n power 4. So you need to get answer is x by 4. Okay, see, you can remember easily also. So whatever here, instead of x, suppose x square is there, what will be the answer? X square by 3 only. Okay, so whatever the function is there, that function will come in the numerator, and whatever the n power is there, that will come in the denominator. See, if earlier problem was you observe and denominator n square is there, so answer x by 2 you got. Here n power 4 is there, so answer will be what? X by 4. Next to L Hospital's rule. Then how to eliminate indeterminate forms in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. So whenever if we apply the limit of the function directly, if you apply the limit of the function, limit if you apply directly, suppose if you got in the form of either 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form, then we can apply L Hospital's rule. But blindly don't apply for every problem LHospitals rule if you got 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity immediately. So think about the problem and alternative method, like expansion method. Further, I will discuss that expansions method or using some standard limits. So if it is easy to differentiate, then approach LHospitals rule. Then if you got 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form, suppose if you got 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form, if you apply limit directly, you can apply LHospitals rule, no problem. But if it is easy to differentiate numerator and denominator separately, then only apply LHospitals rule, or else think about alternative method. It is my suggestion. Okay, so example, so you know we are LHospitals rule, you know, no? So what is LHospitals rule? What is the statement? So what is the LHospitals rule statement? Suppose if we limit extends to a, if the given function in the form of f of x by g of x, and if it is takes the in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form, then how to evaluate this limit? So we can't apply limit directly, then we have to use the LHospitals rule. From LHospitals rule, what it says, the limit of this function is same as limit extends to a f dash x by g dash x. Means you differentiate numerator and denominator separately, don't use UYV formula. So after differentiating numerator and denominator, now you apply the limit. Suppose still you are getting 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form, then further again you differentiate numerator and denominator. That means once again you apply LHospitals rule. So like this, we can apply this LHospitals rule finite number of times. Okay. So one example, simple example, very very simple example, limit extends to 2, x square minus 8x plus 12 divided by x square minus 4. So if you apply limit directly, simple problem, very very simple problem. So if you apply limit directly, you will get 0 by 0 form. So we can't apply limit directly. Then one method is what? Factorization method. And another method is here, LHospitals rule. So differentiate numerator, limit extends to 2, 2x minus 8, differentiating. Next to denominator, differentiate, what do you get? 2x. Now if you apply limit, you won't get any 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form. So if you apply limit, what will you get? 2 into 2 minus 8 by 2 into 2. So numerator minus 4, denominator 4. So thus the answer is minus 1. So it is the simplest problem, most simplest problem. Okay. So next level problem on LHospitals rule, based on LHospitals rule problem. LHospitals rule problem. One more. So it is given limit extends to 0. Cos x power 1 by 3 minus cos x power 1 by 2 divided by sin square x. See, if you apply limit directly, what you will get? 0 by 0 form. Check now. You are getting a 0 by 0 form. So cos 0, 1, 1 minus 1, 0 by 0. Then how we can evaluate this? So we have to differentiate. Okay. So differentiate, because here you are getting 0 by 0 form. So differentiate, limit extends to 0. So cos x power 1 by 3, exponent formula, what you will get? 1 by 3 into cos x power 1 by 3 minus 1. 1 by 3 minus 1, what you will get? Minus 2 by 3. Into cos x derivative, what you will get? Minus sin x. And here also, by differentiating cos x power 1 by 2, there also you will get minus sin x. Now, so I am taking that minus sin x outside. Okay. So what you will get here? Minus 1 by 2 cos x power 1 by 2 minus 1 is a minus 1 by 2. The whole term into what you will get? Minus sin x. Divided by sin x, sin square x derivative is what? 2 sin x into cos x. Here, numerator, here place is not there. That is why I am writing here. Into minus sin x.
So here, this sin x and sin x get cancelled. Now you won't get 0 by 0 form. Because of this sin x term, we are getting 0 by 0 form in this stage also actually. But after cancelling that sin x term, now you won't get 0 by 0 form. Now you can apply limit freely. So what you'll get? 1 by 3 into cos 0, 1. 1 by 2 into again cos 0, 1. Into what is left? Minus 1 divided by 2. So simplify, you will get 1 by 12. I'm writing directly.
Next,
one more problem. And before doing that problem, you consider this problem. Limit extends to 0, x minus sin x by x cube. So it is also taking what? 0 by 0. It is also taking 0 by 0 form. So we have to apply LHS rule, and it is easy to differentiate both numerator and denominator. Then limit extends to 0, x minus sin x derivative 1 minus cos x, and x cube derivative 3x square. So 1 by 3 take it outside, then what is left? Limit extends to 0, 1 minus cos x by x square. If we apply limit, still it is in the form of 0 by 0. But we have this formula 1 minus cos x by x square when extending to 2 is 1 by 2. So use that formula 1 by 3 into 1 by 2, which is equal to 1 by 6.
Or if you don't know that formula, also again, once again differentiate. Then your numerator differentiation, what you'll get? Sin x divided by 6x.
So as x tends to 0, sin x by x is 1. What is the left constant? 6. So 1 by 6.
Next
one more problem. Limit extends to 0. 1 by x square minus 1 by sin square x.
So if you apply limit here directly, you will get infinity minus infinity form. So how to eliminate this infinity minus infinity form? You better convert into in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, and hence you can use LHS rule or some standard limits or some formulas. Okay,
here also by taking LCM, then it is converting into 0 by 0 form. So if you take LCM, what will be the LCM here? X square into sin square x. Numerator, what you will get? Sin square x minus x square.
So 0 by 0 form, and don't blindly apply limit, don't blindly apply LHS rule directly.
Why? Because here, differentiating here, x is tending towards 0. 0 power how much is there? 2. When extending to 0, sin x is also tending towards 0. 0 power how much is there? 2. So 0 power 2, 0 power 2, 0 power how much you are getting? 4. That means denominator 4th degree 0 is there. That means to get a finite value or to get the limit of this function, at most we have to differentiate 4 times. And it is not so easy differentiating 4 times x square into sin square x. So then what we have to do? So here you have to recall one formula: as x tends to 0, sin x by x is tending to 1. So here sin square x is there, so divide with x square and multiply with x square.
Limit extends to 0. And moreover, numerator in the form of a square minus b square, use a plus b into a minus b. I'm going to use this problem as a formula in this problem. Okay?
So what you will get? Sin x minus x into sin x plus x divided by x power 4 into 1 upon sin square x by x square.
Can be written as sin x by x whole square. That means I am dividing with x square, multiplying with x square. It is already x square is there, x square into x square, x power 4.
So now this limit becomes what? 1. That means I am applying limit extends to 0 for these two functions separately. Okay? Now, limit extends to 0. In sin x minus x, you take minus common, x minus sin x, and into x plus sin x. And the denominator x power 4 you split into like this, x cube and x. X cube into x is x power 4. So because x minus sin x by x cube, what you got answer? 1 by 6. And into x is there, still x is there, na? That x you separate like this. Or else you write one step, no problem. Whole divided by x. Now you understood the x cube into x power 4.
I'm not changing the problem.
So, and for this, what is the answer? 1 by 6. That means I'm applying limit of the function for this function and for this function separately. So what is the limit of this function from the previous problem? It is equal to 1 by 6. Then what is left? A limit x tends to 0. Okay, minus into 1 by 6. Minus 1 by 6 outside into limit x tends to 0. X plus sin x by x. So you apply limit separately. So 1 plus sin x by x. Sorry, here separate the numerator. Okay, x by x is 1, sin x by x. So minus 1 by 6 into, if you apply limit, what you'll get? 1 plus sin x by x is 1. So minus 2 by 6, which is equal to minus 1 by 3. So that is the answer. Next one. Next two. How to eliminate 0 into infinity form? So 0 into infinity form, you convert it into 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form. Apply LHS rule or use formulas. Okay. So one example, simple example I'm taking. Limit x tends to 0, x into cot x. So if you apply limit 0 into cot 0. Cot 0 is infinity. So it is taking the form of 0 into infinity. So convert it into 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form. So, how to convert it into 0 by 0 form or infinity into infinity form? See here, I am writing cot x as 1 by tan x. Cot x as 1 by tan x. Thus, it is converted into 0 by 0 form. So, use LHS rule. Or you can use limit x tends to 0 tan x by x is 1. Obviously, reciprocal x by tan x is also reciprocal of 1, 1. So either use the formula or use LHS rule, no problem. Next two. Suppose limit x tends to a f of x value is 1 and limit x tends to a g of x is tending to infinity. Then automatically limit x tends to a f of x power g of x, it takes which form? 1 power infinity form. Here one area base function is tending to 1, not exactly 1. Okay, so 1 power infinity is indeterminate form. Then how to evaluate this? So we have to write like this. So it is equal to e power limit x tends to a. What is the base function? F of x. So base function minus 1 into what is the exponent? G of x. And here, provided that limit x tends to a f of x minus 1 into g of x is exist. So then only we can write like this. Okay. E power limit x tends to a base function minus 1 into exponent function. So for that one, simple example. Limit x tends to 0 is the example problem. 1 plus x whole power 2 by x. So if you apply limit directly, here you consider x value positive. Okay, so clearly it is tending to 1 power infinity. So how to evaluate? Using that above formula. So e power limit x tends to a means here 0. Base function minus 1. Base function is 1 plus x minus 1 into exponent function. Exponent function is 2 by x. So plus 1 minus 1 cancel, then only x left, then this x get cancelled. So limit x tends to 0, 2 is 2 over 2. So thus the answer is e square.
Next, one more simplest problem.
So limit extends to infinity. Limit extends to infinity. X plus 3 by x plus 4 whole power 3x. So as extends to infinity, this x plus 3 by x plus 4 tending to 1. Because degrees are same, leading coefficient by leading coefficient 1. So 3 into infinity, infinity. So 1 power infinity form. So again we have to approach that method. So e power limit extends to, e means here extends to infinity, base function x plus 3 by x plus 4 minus 1 into exponent function 3x. So take LCM and simplify. I'm writing directly here. If you take x plus 4 LCM, numerator becomes what? X plus 3 minus x plus 4 is minus 1 into 3x. So thus e power limit extends to infinity, what you are getting? Minus 1 into 3x, minus 3x divided by x plus 4. Now your extends to infinity, numerator degree, denominator degree, both are same. Then leading coefficient by leading coefficient, here leading coefficient minus 3, here leading coefficient 1. So thus the limit of this function is minus 3 by 1, which is minus 3. Thus the answer is e power minus 3 or 1 upon e cube. So you try this problem, limit extends to 3, log of 3x to the base 3 power log 3 base x. So I'm giving just hint. So log of 3x can be written as log 3 plus log x. Anyway, base 3 only, na? Log 3 base 3 value, what you'll get? 1 power log 3 base x, you write log 3 by log x. Now if you apply, one second, log 3 base x, not base x, oh here, yeah, extending to 1, log 3. Now if you apply 1 plus log 1, 0, 1 power log 3 by log 1, 0, 1 power infinity form, you can apply. That is limit extends to 1, not 3. Homework, okay. Next term, how to eliminate 0 power 0 and infinity power 0 form. That means when we apply limit, the base function is tending to 0 or infinity, and whereas exponent function is tending to 0. So for this kind of problems, you use this formula, e power limit extends to a. What is the log of f of x power g of x? So log of f of x power g of x is g of x into log of f of x. G of x into log of f of x. It is base e. So I am using this form, e power log x is equal to x. Suppose if this is like x, then this can be written as e power log x. So log x means here, instead of x, what do we have? Fx power gx. Log fx power gx is gx into log fx. So one example for this, limit extends to 0, x power x. So clearly it is taking 0 power 0 form, here clearly x is positive. Because this is exponent function, this exponent function is defined only when this base is positive. So 0 power 0 form, how to evaluate? So using this formula, so e power limit extends to 0, here both g and f is x only. So what you will get? X into log x. So one step is completed, one step is completed. Now apply the limit, what you are getting? 0 into, log 0 is what? Undefined. So it is taking 0 into infinity form. So further we have to convert it into 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form, and hence we have to use L'Hospital's rule. Okay? So e power limit extends to 0, I'm going to convert it into 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form by writing x into log x as log x by 1 by x or x by 1 by log x.
x divided by 1 by log x or log x divided by 1 by x. Among these two options, log x divided by 1 by x option is good.
So log x divided by 1 by x. Now it is converted into infinity by infinity form. So to evaluate infinity by infinity, whenever if you apply limit directly, you are getting infinity by infinity form. To evaluate such limits, we can use L'Hospital's rule.
So there is no formula, I am applying L'Hospital's rule.
So log x derivative 1 by x divided by 1 by x derivative minus 1 by x square. So that's what you will get, e power limit x tends to 0. So plus 1 by minus 1, minus 1. So this becomes, after simplifying, x square by x is, which is x. Now applying the limit, what you will get, e power 0, which is equal to 1. So thus, limit x tends to 0, x power x is equal to 1. And you try, limit x tends to 0, x power sine x. This is also taking 0 power 0. 0 power 0. Even you take ulta also, limit x tends to 0 sine x power x, two problems. External. So with this, all methods are completed. All that are 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, L'Hospital's rule, 0 into infinity form, convert 0 into infinity or infinity minus infinity form is there, convert them into 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form, apply L'Hospital's rule or use corresponding formulas. Next to 1 power infinity, one method, 0 power 0, infinity power 0, one more method. So infinity power 0, you try this problem also. Infinity power 0, limit extends to 0. Log x to the base e whole power x. Here to be understood, x positive. Because ln x is defined only when x is positive. See, this ln x means what? Log x to the base e. So when x tending to 0, ln x is tending to infinity, infinity power 0 form.
Thank you.